Hola, bienvenidos. It is an honor and a blessing to do worship together in this beautiful day that the Lord has made so we can be together with the help of this amazing technology. Let's start with a prayer. We are chosen people. No accident, no second best. Each one at the center of your heart. We are royal priesthood. Children of the King, heirs and bringers of the kingdom. You have called us out of darkness and into your wonderful light. Help us, Lord, to declare your praise. Amen. Today's gospel reading comes from the book of Mark, chapter 9, starting from verse 38. John said to Jesus, "Teacher, we saw someone throwing demons out in your name, and we tried to stop him because he wasn't following us." Jesus replied, "Don't stop him. No one who does powerful acts in my name can quickly turn around and curse me. Whoever isn't against us is for us. I assure you that whoever gives you a cup of water to drink because you belong to Christ will certainly be rewarded. As for whoever causes these little ones who believe in me to trip and fall into sin, it will be better for them to have a huge stone hung around their necks and to be thrown into the lake. If your hand causes you to fall into sin, chop it off. It's better for you to enter into life crippled than go away with two hands into the fire of hell, which can't be put out. If your foot causes you to fall into sin, chop it off. It's better for you to enter life lame than to be thrown into hell with two feet. If your eye causes you to fall into sin, tear it out. It is better for you to enter God's kingdom with one eye than to be thrown into hell with two. That's a place where worms don't die and the fire never goes out. Everyone will be salted with fire. Salt is good, but if salt loses its saltiness, how it will become salty again? Maintain salt among yourselves and keep peace with each other. A lot of things to reflect, to discern, and to study in today's gospel. I will start from backwards. Jesus ended saying, keep peace with each other. Keep peace with each other. Sometimes it's easy to say, but not that easy to do, right? Sometimes we focus on the wrong thing, probably, and that makes it harder. And then going back a little bit, when Jesus said, if your hand, if your foot, if your eye makes you fall or causes you to fall into sin, chop it off. He was referring to walk away from whatever thing or whatever situation is causing you to sin. And then we go to this, to the beginning, to the start of this gospel, with John telling Jesus, hey, there was someone else casting out demons in your name, but we stop it because he was not one of us, or he was not following us. What was John's concern? He was jealous about this person because some disciples couldn't cast out demons a few chapters before, or he was worried about Jesus, or what he was worried about, what the people will think, that person was similar to Jesus. But Jesus' response to John's was simple but deep. Don't stop him. Don't stop him. If we apply all of this in today's context, that interaction between John and Jesus, if we apply it in today's context, what we will get. And I made some bullet points. I think there are 9. So I will try to go quickly as possible, but without leaving anything out. And the first one is inclusivity. Just as Jesus recognized the validity of someone performing good works in his name, we can also embrace diversity within our communities. Sometimes we don't have to understand everything that what they are doing or what they are doing. Finding Jesus in a different context is not impossible. If we're open to the lead of the Holy Spirit, we will find Jesus in that context, in that situation. We will see the good deeds of that person. Instead of focusing on differences, we should celebrate shared values and work together for a common purpose. Jesus said that we are not to exclude people. So once again, inclusivity. Number 2, supporting others' good deeds. Jesus is encouraging us to support those who do good, even if we don't share the exact beliefs or methods. In today's context, this can mean collaborating with different organizations. The same way that we work with the food bank or the Lighthouse Ministry, or we work at schools, and sometimes we interact in our work or when we are serving with people that have different faith practice. And we should support each other. We should celebrate that we are there working together for the common good, serving our neighbor and showing the love of God. But we also need to recognize those shared values. That idea of whoever isn't against us is for us can help us to find a common ground with others. In discussions about social issues or community initiatives, we should be seeking unity and agreement rather than division. Every time that we want to help, every time that there's a project to help our community, to help our neighbor, we should be seeking for unity and agreement rather than division. Unity, unidad, in Spanish, unidad. Put it on the side. We will go back to that word, unity, unidad. Number 4, acts of kindness. Jesus mentioned of a simple act, like giving a cup of water. This highlights the importance of a small, everyday act of kindness. love and kindness is a common ground between different practice of faith, between different characters, between different ways to help someone. We can focus on how we treat others, making a conscious effort to show compassion, and we said that Jesus compassion that take us to action. Recognizing that these actions have a significant value for everyone. Helping out someone, serving someone, it will help our transformation, but also it will show them God's love. And everything that we do is better in community. So we should encourage others to keep doing those good works, even if we don't have the same method. But we should encourage also the ones who are not doing anything. How can we help them to serve, to find life, and to find that value in their lives of serving someone else? Sharing God's love through service, through a community dinner, to helping at the food bank. Doesn't matter what is our activity assigned. The important thing is that we're there to serve, to make a difference in someone else's life. We should evaluate our intentions. We can reflect on our intentions, especially when we critique others. We're trying to serve with kindness, or are we trying to uphold standards or acting out of fear or insecurity? Understanding this can help us to be more positive and cooperative. Let's just serve together. Let's enjoy our siblings that are serving. This will reward kindness. Recognizing and rewarding kindness with a special word, encouraging verbally or any other way, can motivate more people to engage in these acts of service and generosity. Number eight is when we brought back that word unidad, unity. Searching for that common ground, I was trying to search for a deep meaning of unity. And while I was doing that search, I said, wait a minute, we are radically inclusive. So I should look for radically unity. And I found this. The term radical comes from the Latin word radix, which mean roots. Radical comes from the Latin word radix, which mean roots. We view an action as radical when it reaches beneath the surface. A change is considered radical when it dwells into the root. Since roots grow underground, they are often invisible, but it doesn't mean that because we don't see them, they're not there. So our unity is radical because it's deeply underground. In other words, our shared ground exists even if it is below the surface. So what about if we go deep in relationships? Love your neighbor, love your enemy. Love your neighbor, love your enemy. Ama a tu prójimo, love your neighbor. What about if we go deep in service? Serve, servir, serve your community. Serve everyone around you. Not only one, the ones you know. Serve everyone around you. If we go deep in prayer, si vamos a una oración en profundidad, deep in prayer. You can pray by yourself. You can pray with your siblings that attend your same church. But even if you attend the same church, not everyone has the similar method or way of prayer. But if you are with someone, serving with someone that has a different Christian denomination, if you cannot have a common ground, there is one. Pray the Lord's Prayer. And if you are with someone with a different faith belief, first listen to their prayer. Reflect and be thankful for listening to God in a different way. What about if we go deep on love? Always, always the common ground. And it should be broad into the surface. If you found that love is the common ground, but it's still underground, it should be brought into the surface. How can we do that? With practice, practice, and kindness. What about if we go deep in service? Jesus said, whoever gives you a cup of water to drink because you belong to Christ will certainly be rewarded. Jesus loves everyone. I was reading a book that the name of the book is My Neighbor's Faith, Stories of Interreligious Encounter, Growth and Transformation, by Jennifer Howie and Rose Peace. On page 111 on the Kindle edition, it says, in the end, for me, interreligious engagement is not about changing someone's theology. It's about developing the skill to engage productively across lines of difference. Can we learn to disagree on matters of faith without turning out to violence? Do we recognize our common humanity? Can we cooperate on joint projects for the common good? Religion is too often a source of bitter dispute and a bloody conflict. However, if people of faith are also people in search of peace and justice, then perhaps we can transform our religious borders and reach a point of mutual respect and cooperation, emerging from our faith commitments and not despite them. What profound and beautiful thoughts. So even if we don't have a common ground above the surface, below the surface, that radically those roots are our common ground. And when we found that underground is our common ground, we also remember that underground is our common ground with Jesus. That underground is where we were buried with Jesus in our baptism and rise to live a continued resurrection of life. Today, I encourage you to go out and build a more collaborative, compassionate community that values contribution from all individuals, regardless of their background or beliefs. And God's people say, Amen. Thank you. Together, let's pray as Jesus taught us. I will pray in Spanish. You can follow the words on the screen. Padre nuestro que estás en los cielos, santificado sea tu nombre. Venga tu reino, hágase tu voluntad en la tierra como en el cielo. Danos hoy nuestro pan de cada día y perdona nuestras ofensas como nosotros perdonamos a los que nos ofenden. No nos dejes caer en tentación y líbranos del mal. Porque tuyo es el reino, el poder y la gloria por los siglos de los siglos. Amen. Before we go, remember common ground. Even if it's underground, will remind us about our baptism. That baptism, that it is a continued journey, life journey, that where we are growing in transformation and in resurrection. And receive this benediction. The grace of the Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Amen.